Hello everyone, welcome back to Yakuza Games. Today I'm going to show you how to replace the voltage regulator on these Yuvo FC game consoles. Now, if you recall from my previous review, I didn't review these very well because the things wouldn't power on, and somebody had actually commented that it would it could be the voltage regulator on this guy here, and I've already done it to this other one that I have here, and it powers on again. So yeah, that was a culprit, and I'm going to show you exactly where this item is here. Basically, you're going to have to do is unsolder the old one, if you notice here, and resolder a new one on there. If you notice, you can get these at RadioShack. It's a 7805 voltage regulator, 1 amp, and basically, in order to get to this, you gotta unscrew the 4 screws that are here. There's usually on these little stoppers, I guess you could say, to prevent the system from moving. You're gonna have to remove those first of all, and then you can get to the screws. And then the way you want to open this is to lift it somewhat like a book, because if you notice here, there's an LED that's connected to the top portion of the system, so you don't want to accidentally mess that up there. Let's see there. But yeah, the voltage regulator is actually right here towards the power source where you plug in your adapter. And you'll have 3 screws, 1, 2, and 3. And this part here will come straight out. I do highly recommend, though, that you do unscrew the rest of these guys. It'll be 1 and 2. And you'll notice there's 3 others right here. 1, 2, and 3. That way you can flip it upside down, because all these guys here, if you notice, they're actually glued together. And yeah, you don't want to create any extra problems. You want it to be as easy as possible as far as unsoldering and soldering. So let me get to that, and I'll show you more of how to take this guy off. Alright guys, one thing you might want to note is to unscrew this guy as well. He has 1 screw similar to this one on the left side, and you can pull this straight out so there's no tension, because you could actually pull this guy out on accident, and then that'll cause you to have to resolder that as well. But yeah, now that everything is unsoldered, you can actually remove these guys from the base of the system. And let's see here. These are the 3 guys here you're going to have to unsolder. Since there's 3 tabs to this guy here, yeah, it's a quick note is to, you know, have the solder across, and you could actually heat them up at the same time. But you want to watch out that you don't accidentally make them connect when you have it unsoldered and resoldered. So keep that as a note. And yeah, all we have to do is unsolder that, and we'll pop in the new guy, and I'll show you how that looks. Oh yeah, before I forget, if you're working on this guy here, just for future reference, if you forget which way it's facing, the black side is actually facing outward towards the output. So yeah, keep that in mind when you're placing the new voltage regulator. Alright guys, I have it all soldered in there. Not the best job in the world, but I actually need to get a new tip. But yeah, that definitely does the job. Just as a quick note, again, make sure that none of the solder, when you resolder this back on there, is actually in contact with one another, because, of course, they're in close proximity. And yeah, you could possibly accidentally connect them, and you want to avoid that at all costs. But yeah, let's go ahead and connect all this back together, and we'll see if it fires up. Alright guys, I have it all hooked back together. The moment of truth now. I'm going to try to fire this guy up. As you can see there, it's working just like it was brand new again. I want to make a special thanks to Ace9921 for giving me this little tip here. And again, that voltage regulator is a 7805 plus 5 volt DC 1 amp. You can find these at RadioShack for under $2. Thanks again. This is Agent Zero for Yakuza Games, and I'll talk to you guys next time.